Good morning, soul family. I know that with this most recent full moon illumination, there's been a lot of new seekers, new awakeners, a sudden jolt of all of a sudden awareness and acclimation to the energies afoot has been initiated. I've felt it, I've been feeling it, and this has also done something to the long time awakener makers. That's funny. Awakener makers. Those of us who have been on this path for a while now, those of us who have been who have gone from seeking to attempting to understand. There's different stages, as most of you know. And really what I have been gleaning from all of this is that there is some new energy work and weaving that is needed from us all for us to sync up and to acclimate to each other as well. And to it's going to assist each other, you know, both the old timers and the novices. It's going to assist us because a lot of us have been kind of just waiting for what it is that our purpose is. Like, and really this is it. This is that moment that we've all been waiting to grace us with. It's time to sync up. It's time to start sharing. It's time. We have all of the right cogs in place for that to occur. Everything has screeched to a halt. We have all gotten that opportunity to become more dot-like. And now it's time, now that we've reclaimed all of that energy. For a little more information on this, go ahead and watch my most recent video before this one. Becoming dot-like is part of the title. We've reclaimed all of that energy back to the core of who we are. It's all still gathering back to us. Now we need to determine where to allocate it. Let's make a better choice this time, and let's make it together. I awoke this morning with light language in my heart, yearning to be on my lips. And I feel compelled to share some codes that will assist in this transition. Weaving the cords of the sacral, learning to accept, learning to understand, learning to feel held, supported, secured. I want a nice soul, and I say, I want a nice soul, and I say, say, night, I soul. Slowly merge that what the solar plexus which will help it transmute it from our core to our extremities to all of the other places within us for us to work with this as we handle and manipulate our 3D world. Feel that as it transmutes and transforms its way through your cells, and watch your cells all have fingers that unclasp. It's time to let go. It's time to stop resisting. It's time for acquiescence. For a deeper understanding that comes from simplicity. From simply noticing. From simply turning your gaze to something outside yourself and realizing that that is also you. Not thinking about it, not using the brain of your body, but feeling it. Feeling it with that which you came here with on the day of your birth. And that which will always continue with you after you have shed this body. Let's move the energy upward. Let's bring it up a bit more. I feel some clearing needed in the heart. Hi, hi, nai nai shai. Hi, 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 nai. Breathe into the transference and the movement that you'll feel from this. It's time for us to begin sharing our voices, but our true voices, not the voices of noise, of ego, of this human world. The voices that are within us, of which we all have many. The voices, the expressions that share this experience with all of us. Moving upward into our throat chakra for guidance and assistance with this. As you breathe, feel your throat open. Feel the openness. The openness within you, the openness within the space before you. Even if there is so much happening, there is an openness that you can feel into. We'll save the third eye and the crown for a part two of this sequence. I've been guided to say that tomorrow morning is the time and place. Thank you for joining me, and continue to breathe into these transmutations of your energetic self. Because I love you, soul family, and I'm here for you through this time. Please join me live on my Facebook group every Saturday at 8 p.m. Please reach out to me on Instagram or by email. I would love to connect with you. I offer free readings on my Facebook Live and sometimes free light language. It depends on what I'm guided to share and to provide. I am here to serve. I've known this for a long time. This new climate, this new paradigm shift, this new awakening and change is allowing me to do so. And I'm here with all of you to help you to learn and to feel into that space of who you really are. Continue to breathe into this and look for more light language in part two.